10-yard line. Shotgun formation, snap to Eason. The rush is on. Nowhere to go. Sack back at the 16-yard line. Third sack of the day.
Out and 15, back to the 41-yard line in Chicago territory. And Montana goes down at midfield, and it was Mike McMichael again. You know, he is outstanding again. McMichael on his record-setting day, and he's
defense against the wide receiver core.
Yard line, shotgun formation, snap to Eason. The rush is on, nowhere to go. Sack back at the 16-yard line. Third sack of the day.
Out and 15, back to the 41-yard
line. No marshmallow. Oh, Jesus.
Goes down at midfield. Michael again.
No. Hi guys, I'm so glad you made it. Yes, we got two calls actually from the Hall of Fame yesterday. The first one was from Jim Porter, the president, and he said we made the final three. So I'm happy. I think that means we're going to Canton next August. He said sometimes they'll meet again before Super Bowl and go over it again. And sometimes they pick one, sometimes they pick two. But he said last year they picked all three, and I really hope they pick all three nominees again. And I know even if they just pick one, it's going to be Steve. So let's go to Canton, everybody. Let's go next year. I'm so excited.
Tell me how Steve's eyes lit up when you gave him the news, Misty.
Well, you know what? He was asleep, but when I woke him up, he raised his eyebrows like, yeah. And when we made the cut to the 12, he put on the computer, let's go to Canton. So he's ready. He wants to go. So I need a medical airplane and a medical ambulance to get him there. Anybody?
This has been something that you, along with Betsy Shepherd and Team Mongo, have been working on for over a year.
Well, you know what? He's been nominated several times over the years, and we've been working on it for years. But once we got the nomination this year and it went from 100 to 31, I just knew it was happening finally, and I started working my butt off. I got a podcast every Monday night called Monsters of the Madhouse at Bridges Scoreboard Bar, and it's Chicago sports podcasting, and I've been interviewing all the 85 guys and pubbing him for the hall, and it's been great. Jimbo Covert's going to be my guest this coming Monday, and we're going to keep pubbing him until we get to Canton. but it's been awesome just being able to get up there and speak for him since he can't speak for himself. He's already, the stats have been there for years, and all I have to do is talk about him.
Mr. What do you think it is that put him over the top this year?
The ALS. I really do. I think that nobody wants another Ron Santos situation, and we know he's running out of time. You know, he almost died this last time, and I had to rip up his DNR because of the Hall of Fame. So because of the Hall of Fame is why he's still alive.
Misty, what has the pursuit of this meant to you guys as you deal with a very difficult thing?
No, you know what? It's given us a mission. Spot. It's given us a mission and something else to focus on besides death. You know, it's given us life and another year with him. And I can't ask for more than that. I want the most time we have with him, and this is going to make sure we have more time.
Fair to assume that yesterday was one of his best days in a long time?
Yesterday was so awesome, but then putting a muzzle on me was hard until today. So I'm saying, yes, we're in. It's down to the last three. He's the top of the list, and I'm so excited. Yeah, it was an awesome day. We had ESPN over here, and it was so much fun just to wait on it and, get it. And I want to, it's the first time that a gold jacket gets cut up the back so somebody can put it on.
How tough was that last night, being at the party and not wanting?
Oh, well, you know, I planned the party because I knew the call was going to come that day, and I just assumed that I was going to be able to talk about it at the party. So that's kind of why we had it there, you know. But when they told me to be quiet, that's fine and all. I did my best, and we still had a great time. And I told them, I said, it's kind of like the Super Bowl shuffle. They filmed that before they won the Super Bowl. So, you know, I was just kind of partying before the official party. Yeah. It was great. The Loop Rockers performed at the party, and they sang Summer of 69, and I got up there and sang with them, and we changed the lyrics to Summer of 76. It was great. It was a great time.
The support from the community has been overwhelming, and we saw that at the hospital as a small example of it.
That was amazing, wasn't it? That was when I knew for sure, because just how it all came together out of the blue, with all those cops and firemen, because he'd always done so much for first responders, and they all came out for us. And the mayor of Homer Glen even had me at her town hall meeting and did a proposition for Steve to get into the Hall of Fame. And she has the ALS flower is the sunflower, and she has the tattoo on her forearm. Just all these signs, you know, that let me know that I should have turned my phone off, and but also that we're going to Canton. It's happening, it's finally happening.
Misty, Jim McMahon, among many of the other 85 members, were out in front with the push to get Steve in the Hall.
Don't get rid of that, yeah.
Can you talk a little bit about what his teammates...
This is George McCaskey.
Oh, George McCaskey. George! George! Hello?
Hi, no, this is May, Kevin Warren's assistant. How are you?
I'm actually on Fox Live TV right now, pubbing the Hall of Fame, so I was going to get you on TV right now. I hope so. Yeah, put your TV on Fox at noon.
I will. Okay. So what I'm calling you about, Misty, like I said, I'm Kevin Warren's assistant. Kevin and George would like to come by on Tuesday at 2 o'clock. Will that be okay with you and Steve?
That would be awesome. You'd come by Tuesday at 2.
Tuesday at 2. They'll see you then, okay?
Thank you so much.
All right. Thank you, and congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Uh-huh.
Bye. Tuesday at 2, the McCaskies are coming. So that's awesome.
No, just put the mic in the
right. Oh. Oh, cool.
So it wasn't George who was his assistant?
It was that guy Kevin that called me earlier, his assistant.
Kevin Warren's assistant, manager.
That's right. Okay. But yeah, I know George. George has been over here to visit. He's a great guy, and so is Brian. They've been very helpful through all of this.
I was going to say, talk about how supportive the Bears organization has been throughout.
You know what? They have been so awesome. Like, even when we first got diagnosed is when I was really needing help, because I hadn't gotten the Plan 88 yet to help us out and stuff, and it hadn't kicked in yet. And I told George and Brian, and Brian actually paid for half of his hospital bed. They're like 20 grand. And then they bought the wheelchair. Those were like 100 grand. You know, so they really helped us out a lot on big expenses. And they've been very supportive. Anything I need, Brian and George, they're funny, they're brothers, so they're competitive. If I give one brother a t-shirt, the other one wants one too. And that's fine, because they can have whatever they want. But yeah, they've been awesome, just super cool.
And the teammates?
Oh my God.
It's just been a parade of teammates.
It has been, and that's what is probably kept him alive too, the love, because that's what I've noticed with ALS. Guys, if they're at home and they have a lot of support and love, they last longer. And you know, Kevin Butler comes all the time when he's in town from Georgia. Jim McMahon was just here again, and he lives in Arizona. They fly in. You know, Doug Plank even came from Arizona.
Hamp's been living here.
Oh, Hamp's been over a lot, yeah. Otis, Richard, Mike Singletary's flown in from Texas. All the guys. I've even met through my podcast, players that I didn't even know were on the team that have been super supportive. I think his name's Craig Williams or something. We did a podcast, and he had all the guys from the 85 team's jerseys that have been in the Hall of Fame, and he had a spot for Steve.
Wow.
Yeah. So it's been super cool.
Rick
Flair is awesome. He's a super good friend. Steve was one of the four horsemen with him at the WCW. He's been over all the time. He gives us some of his Ric Flair drip that he's doing with Mike Tyson. Helps me too. So yeah, he's awesome. Super sweetheart.
Misty, you were talking about the gold jacket. Do you envision him being...
Oh, I can already see myself cutting it up on stage and putting it on him.
Do you envision him being there?
Oh, yeah, I do. He wants to go, and I'm going to do everything I can to get him there if I have to get a plane myself. But it needs to be a medical airplane to fit a gurney, because he can't really sit in his chair very long anymore from bed sores. So it's going to have to be a medical ambulance gurney to a medical airplane, gurney him up onto the stage. And then I'll cut that coat and put it on him.
And then it'll be Jarrett.
And Jarrett. Oh, for sure. He wants Jarrett. Yeah. You know, Jarrett played for him in the Chicago Slaughter indoor football team and helped Steve win a championship. They won their first championship with Jarrett, and Jarrett made his first touchdown with Steve. So that's like his boy, you know. So, yeah, he's grown up with Steve from so baby. I think Steve changed his diapers, you know. So that's how close they are. Yeah, and I love, well, I love Eddie, his uncle. Eddie calls all the time, and that man is so hilarious. I actually had him on one of my podcasts, and I had a little too much to drink, a lot too much to drink.
Imagine that.
And he and I got so out of hand, they had to take that one down. You can't find that one. And they said, if you behave like that again, you're closed for 30 days. So Eddie's awesome. Yeah.
Before you got the phone call, I was just asking about Jim McMahon's role specifically in pushing this.
Jimmy Mack, you know what? He's always been there for us over before EILS and everything. Anything Steve got inducted into, like the Chicagoland Sports Hall of Fame, the Gridiron Greats Hall of Fame, Jimmy Mack's right there, just supporting and supporting and supporting. He's my second favorite bear. You know, he's awesome. Yeah, he's super cool.
Misty, you've thought through all the details of what this would be like.
I have.
Next August, a year from now, it seems like you can...
I can envision it. Oh, I see it all. Just like I saw all this. Yeah. Oh, it's happening. It's happening. It's finally happening. You know, we've waited a long time. He has. And I just want him to be able to die in peace and know how badass he is. He knows, and everybody else knows, but I want the whole world to know. You know? I want everyone to know that he deserves this, and he's deserved it for a long time. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Misty, I know that there's probably a community rallying around you, but talk about what this is like for you as wife, as you know, you're bearing the burden of a lot of this with this diagnosis, but there's probably a lot of...
There's a lot of blessings. You're going to make me cry. It's not a burden when you love somebody, but it just, you just want to do everything you can for them, and I think this is the best thing that I can do for him, and... It's not a burden, it's a blessing. He's been the biggest blessing in my life. You know, we've been married 22 years together, 25, that's like my whole life. And I don't know what I'm gonna do without him, but I'm gonna be able to get through it knowing that I did my best. I did my best for him. And so, yeah. He's gonna get in, and then he can die in peace. Well, you know, he's lost his voice, but we have the Toby Dynavox computer that Steve Gleason is another football player that was afflicted with ALS. Oh, sorry. I guess I didn't put yours in good enough. He's another player that had ALS or has ALS, and he has the foundation, this Gleason Foundation, and they provide you with the Toby Dynavox computers, and they're eye-gazing computers so that you're able to look into the screen with your eyes and create a sentence. And when Jarrett and I were back there a while ago, he created ass on fire. He wanted his nurse to rub his, you know, put cream on his butt. But he says, good morning, I love you. You know, he can say anything on that thing. I'll spare you some of the things he said, but they're funny. Show me your tits, you know, that's Steve. Just anything.
Did you know the other two finalists?
You know what? I'm not positive.
The Hall of Fame just released it.
What is it?
Randy Grashear.
Randy Gratishar.
Gratishar and Art Holland.
Oh, I was wrong.
Wow.
But Steve McMichael's on there.
Steve McMichael.
Number one, baby. I never heard of those other two players, so you know who's going in. Yeah. We know. We all know. So let's just admit it. Steve's going to be in the Hall of Fame. Class of 2024. August, we're going to be at Canton, and it's going to be the biggest turnout. Steve's going to make the Hall of Fame famous because nobody really knows how they work, what they're doing, where they're at, da-da-da. I've learned so much about them, and we're doing a caravan. Let me show you this. We're doing a caravan to Canton. We've already got the flyers printed up. Caravan to Canton, and everybody's going to be there for Steve. All the fans are coming from Chicago, all his family. It's going to be the biggest turnout they've ever seen, and we're going to put him on the map. So, yeah, I hope to see you all there. Oh, yeah, you can take it. Okay, there's cool. Plenty of copies for y'all. Yeah, put that out there. We're getting it started already. We're getting everybody ready to go to, you know, Canton. That's going to be the biggest thing next August sees.
It's going to be the biggest induction the Hall of Fame's ever seen. I can promise you that. It's going to be great. Yeah. And that's the guys that threw the party last night are putting this together. So he has a whole bunch of people that just want to do everything they can for him. Because you know what? He gave so much to everybody when he was healthy. He raised more money for charity than he ever took in for himself. I don't know anybody in any profession that can say that. So he deserves all this love coming back when he needs it the most. And I'm just really happy and excited for him.
Have you heard from Coach Dickey yet?
I heard, yes, I did. Coach and Diana were very close friends of ours that when we first moved here 20 years ago, were the ones that we hung out with at Dicka's on Chestnut every Thursday up there upstairs. John Vincent, we were the first couple he met before he started singing, and he's a big famous guy now. But yeah, Diana, Mike's in pretty bad health right now. He's not mobile, and she just broke a hip and all, but she's more mobile. So she called twice and said she had heard about us being in the hospital with pneumonia, and she was calling to check to make sure that he was home and okay. Yeah, yeah, they're awesome. The Dickas, they're in Florida where they should be, because it's nice down there and it's probably better weather for them. But I hope I see them soon because they're really great.
Speaking of his health, is he a lot better now from when he was in the hospital?
Well, it was so bad when we went in this last time because of the DNR. The DNR thing, we ripped up at the last minute because of the Hall of Fame induction. And right when I called 911, he went unconscious. But when we got to the hospital, he was unconscious all night, but he woke up the next morning. And we did the 10 days of antibiotics at home because he hates the hospital, doesn't want to be there. So when we came home, we did the 10 days, but he has pneumonia still. So we're going to have to order another round of antibiotics, which scares me because we've been home with IV antibiotics before, but we've never had to do a second round. So let's keep our prayers that he's going to pull through this bout of pneumonia. I think he will. Because of all this, but yeah, he's still sick. So I didn't go to the party last night because I didn't want him to catch anything from anybody with the pneumonia that he already has. So yeah, we're waiting on the second round of antibiotics so that we can get him well.
That's tough on the body.
Well, you know, he only has one lung left, so it's very hard. Yeah, an organ failure is the only thing you can't recover from. So I can't have that. I can't have organ failure because that's death. So we got to keep that one lung going. He's on a respirator, which is artificial life. So I'm hoping that thing works through the pneumonia and everything. Yeah, he's on a ventilator. So I'm doing my best. And so are you guys. Thank you. I think this is all helping him stay alive and fight that pneumonia.
Thank you for allowing us in today.
Oh my God! Anytime it's for Steve.
Sharing the great news.
Yeah. Yes. Finally, I get to say something. We're in. Yeah. Yeah. My dogs. Boo Boo, you were right here. Good boy.
Do you want to kind of organize something so that people can get a shot or two one at a time?
Yeah. I want to go back there and get a shot of Steve. I think he's up.
We don't want to overwhelm him again.
No, one at a time. I think he's awake. Let me go see.
But Jay, you want to come back for a shot?
Thank you.
Oh,
whatever, yeah.
Thank you.
Does anybody else have a live fitness?
Do you
want to go back?
Here? Go ahead.
Yeah, go
Mike.
First, yeah.
Mike, if you want to go first, that's fine. Sure. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it doesn't matter when we go.
Yeah,
so let's go set up for the live shot.
Where do you want to do the live?
So there you go. You've heard it here, WGN News Now. We just gave it to you live as Misty McMichael made it official publicly that her husband, Steve Mongo McMichael, Bears great, 1985, those huge diehard Chicago Bears fans know him well, that he is in the final three for the NFL Hall of Fame. Now, we were hearing at the end there that they're actually, she was checking to see how Steve's condition was, if he was awake, if they were going to allow cameras into his room, and it sounds like one at a time, the photographers are actually going to go back get a little bit of video of him in his state, see what reaction he can provide to the news. And then we have our own Mike Lowe. He is the one in the room, literally, at this point. And he is going to be doing a live shot in about 20 minutes on WGN, our midday newscast. So the reason that it's in black right now, that just means that the transmitter is still sending, but they've disconnected it. That's probably because they're on their way to that room. So I'm going to go ahead and wrap up the live stream that I've been doing. But no, his live shot is coming up, as I said, in about 20 minutes on WGN. If you can catch that over broadcast, it, you know, we still send out that broadcast signal. It doesn't matter if you're paying for cable or not. You get one of those really affordable receivers, antenna of sorts, and you can still get that signal for free. Or we are live streaming, WGNTV.com, the WGN app, our over-the-top WGN Plus app. Lots of options for you to catch Mike's report here in about 20 minutes. Otherwise, we will be updating our website, WGNTV.com, with that information. Though, as I'm seeing here on Facebook, all the comments coming in there, a lot of people watching, a lot of people now in the know that Mongo is in the final three for selection. It's 1, 2, 3. All three of those could actually be picked up in the Hall of Fame. His wife organizing a caravan to Canton, hoping that they can kind of put a little bit of pressure on it and really show up and show out for Steve Mongo McMichael if he is indeed inducted into the NFL Hall of Fame, which not sure how many of you out there, I've seen a lot of these, like Sean saying, hashtag Team Mongo, will actually take part in the caravan. But Sue, no, he's not officially in. He's in the final three, the committee selection. Now another vote has to take place. And then of those three, 1 to 3 could get selected. And we will find out in August, excuse me, not August, in Canton. Canton Hall of Fame, NFL induction, 2020. That was August 3 through 6, 2023? No, I'm not sure. Is it August 2024? Somebody that knows more sports than me, feel free to chime in and let me know. I believe it is August of next year, 2024, that we find that out, because the enshrinement week just happened August 3 through 6, 2023. So that is a ways to go. Waiting to see anybody confirm or correct me anywhere that I'm watching. No one. Nope, no sports people are near me. I'm sorry, I don't actually know that one. But awesome news nonetheless for the Bears fans, and more to come. Mitch, August 2024, day before Super Bowl. It is the week of Super Bowl 2024. There's all those comments. Thank you. Well, it wouldn't be August then. It would be the week of the Super Bowl, which is February, I believe, is the vote. And then the enshrinement ceremony in August 2024. There we go. Awesome. Thanks. I appreciate the assist, true sports fans out there. So check out Mike Lowe, WGN News, about 20 minutes. Hopefully y'all will tune in and catch his report and what video they were able to get of Steve. Until the next live stream, though, I'm Chip Brewster. Have a good rest of your day.